Eric.
Really?
No. Bad joke. Sorry.
Anyway, hi.
Hi. Please sit down.
Thank you. You look lovely.
Thank you.
Even better than your picture.
Sweet. Your hair is red.
Yeah. Sorry.
Anyway, have you ordered?
Just
a
drink.
Is that a Manhattan?
Yes.
Looks good. Have you eaten here before?
Oh, yes, several times.
Oh, anything you'd suggest?
Yes, lots. the pork loin is really good.
Yeah, I don't eat meat.
the mahi-mahi is really good.
Yeah, but that's meat too.
Fish
is meat.
Fish,
it's an animal that used to be alive, so I don't eat it. Oh, I do eat eggs, but those aren't meat.
They're animals.
They're preemptive animals. Pre-meat.
So you're a vegetarian but not a vegan?
Yes.
Huh. Well, I'd look for something that'll keep your strength up if I were you. We have a long night ahead of us.
We do?
Many adventures at least.
Oh, God. I think I'm too excited to eat now. And nervous.
There's no need to be nervous.
It's just, this is all kind of new for me, Andrea.
Andrea.
Ah, God, I'm sorry.
Eric, don't worry. I'm no pro.
You are? Oh, God, I'm sorry. If I realized. It's, are you really a professional?
No. That's just a saying.
Oh. Okay. Woo!
I mean, if I could get paid for it, that would be amazing.
I'm sorry.
Why do you like to spend money that way?
Well, lots of people spend money on this kind of thing.
Really? Huh. I'll have to look into that.
Oh, but not now.
That's silly. Have you had a chance to decide what you're going to order?
I think I'm just going to stick to a drink to calm my nerves.
Well, I do have some snacks back at my place.
Your place?
Sure, I've got it all set up for us.
All set up? For us?
Yeah, I'm excited. This is gonna be fun.
Oh, I'm excited too. If I'm being honest, yes, I am.
I'll take good care of you.
Promise?
Of course.
Can I ask you a personal question, Andrea?
Thank you. You don't wanna make me mad.
Oh, God, no.
So, how personal is this question?
That's funny. The how personal.
What?
Well, you know, how personal, and we're, you know. No, okay, never mind. Have you ever hurt anyone playing this, doing this? I mean, like really hurt someone?
Well, it's almost impossible to avoid all injuries.
Well, I mean, a certain amount of redness, maybe some swelling.
And occasionally someone will die.
Yeah. Die?
Not my fault.
Oh, whose fault is it?
Well, if someone insists on not following directions or wanders off by themselves, uses a weapon they're not sure of, I mean, I can hardly be responsible for that.
Weapon?
It's all hardly.
I had no idea they were called weapons.
What else do you call them?
This whole culture has its own vocabulary, I guess.
You'll get the hang of it.
I guess I'll just have to trust you.
Of course you can trust me. Now let's get you that drink. We don't want to keep the others waiting.
Others?
Sure, the rest of the party.
It's a party?
You didn't think it was just going to be the two of us, did you?
Well, yeah, I kind of did.
Really? Huh. I've never done it with just one person before.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I could try, but it sounds kind of boring.
I'm sorry. Is this usually a group thing?
Wow, you are new to this. Did you do any research at all before you placed the ad?
Apparently not enough.
I mean, you seem really shocked.
It's just, you're so confident.
Oh, I've just been doing it a long time.
How long?
Since high school.
Really?
A lot of people start then.
Oh, man, I am so vanilla.
Why would you be so skittish? No big deal.
I'm starting to think I might need to ease into this.
Ease into it? I mean, how would that even happen? Either you're in or you're out. Unless you just want to watch.
Oh, is that an option?
I don't know. I'm not doing it. If it doesn't sound like fun, by all means, let's not do it.
Well, it's just, I think maybe we aren't well matched. You seem way more hardcore than I am, so to speak.
Well, how else are you going to learn if not from an expert? It's just a game.
I thought so too, but...
Okay, how about this? If we get into it, and you don't like it, you can leave at any time.
Do you have like a code or a password?
Just try it.
Okay, so... We're gonna go to your place.
Right.
Where you have everything set up.
Yes.
With other participants.
My friends, yes.
And then what?
We go into the dungeon.
Oh god, the dungeon.
I take my job as master very seriously.
And if someone gets hurt, what then?
Well, that's not really my decision.
Whose is it then?
The rest of the parties. They can decide to save the hurt one in some way, or leave them to bleed out if it's hopeless, or in certain circumstances, the injured just disappears.
Oh my god, that is not okay!
I thought this was what you want.
No, it is not. I do not want to be seriously injured. I do not want other people involved, and I certainly don't want to be left to die.
Doesn't what needs to happen? But it's usually worth it anyways, because there's treasure on the other
side.
Oh
my god! Wait, treasure?
Of course. Why else would you go into the dungeon in the first place? Why else would you fight the monsters?
What are we talking about? Dungeons and Dragons?
Well, sure, it's your ad. Got it right here. SWMC, someone, preferably female, to introduce him to the world of D&D. I'm new to this. Please be gentle with me. Blushy face.
Can I see that?
Oh, God.
What?
Oh, there's been a horrible mistake. A typo?
What was it supposed to say?
No, one little letter. One letter in all of this.
What is it?
My mom's even a proofreader.
Oh, no.
Maybe if I would have put the SM part after it, too.
No, you mean DM, Dungeon Master.
No.
D&D SM? What's that?
Oh, God. No, I can't. It's too embarrassing. I should go. No, sorry, it was really nice to meet you.
No big deal, just tell me.
Nope, I am so sorry.
It's no problem.
Really apologize.
Fine.
Okay, goodbye.
Parked in the first... Damn it!
No, wait a second. Is that it there on the ground?
Where?
There.
Oh, no. That's a gum wrapper. I saw it when I was out there.
And you just left it there?
Well, I'm on a tight schedule.
Oh, my gosh. There's a trash can right by the front door!
Stop it.
Wouldn't even take 5 seconds! See?
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm just a little distracted.
All right. Well, do you remember anything?
What, on the list?
Yes, on the list.
I'm trying.
I don't know, what else could I, a stranger, be asking you about?
I don't know.
To get your list, like, could I be asking, like, hey, stranger, do you remember anything, like, at all?
You're not making this any easier.
Yeah, like, do you remember, like, the capital of North Dakota?
Bismarck?
I'm impressed.
Me too.
Are you from there or something?
Iowa.
Oh.
Do you know all the state capitals?
No, I didn't even know I knew that one.
Okay, what about Kentucky?
Frankfort?
Wow!
Why do I know that?
Or Idaho?
Boise.
names of cities because I would not be able to tell.
No, I don't think so.
Okay. When you say it, I think, oh my gosh, he's right, but I would never be able to come up with city names like that.
Well, I wouldn't have thought I could either. Weird.
Yeah. So, okay, so you know all of the state capitals, but not what's on your list for the deli.
You know, it's probably some sort of like elementary school reflex. You know, I was probably tested on it and then it got stored away in some dusty corner of my brain.
Okay. So your deli list isn't like old enough or something.
I wasn't tested on it.
Hmm. Well, can you do that thing with other subjects?
Well, look, I'm at least as shocked as you are.
Like, for example, what's the closest star?
Well, the sun.
Other than the sun.
Oh, Proxima Centauri.
Ah! See, you have a great memory, so think.
Oh, all right.
All right.
Okay. All right. I want a... I want a... Half... Half... Pound of a... A pint of... potato. No, pasta.
Okay, calm down. Okay, so you want a half pint each of potato salad and pasta.
No. We talked about this stuff. We talked about all this stuff, but I can't remember what we decided on. Or three beans.
You know what? Can you please just call her?
What, and give her time to plan my demise? No way, no way. The element of surprise is on my side. Probably.
Does it matter, you know, that much?
Sauerkraut.
Ew.
No, not sauerkraut.
Okay, so I mean, if you bring home any food from here at all, even if it's not on your list, wouldn't that be okay?
Look, you have no idea what led to the creation of this list. Now, are you familiar with World War II?
Okay, a little. I did a show about Hitler's blow-up.
Yeah, well, it's kind of like that. Well, you know, towards the end, when Haiti jumped in.
Wait a second. Haiti was involved in World War II?
Oh yeah, they joined with some South American countries when it became obvious that Germany was going to lose.
That was another one, wasn't it?
This is crazy. Anyway, I'd sooner bring home a pizza than something that wasn't on that list.
Oh my gosh, but you have an amazing memory.
But I don't.
Oh, yes you do. I just met you and even I know that.
But I didn't have to think about any of that stuff. The answers just popped out when you asked the questions.
So maybe your list is like, in there, and if I were to quiz you on things...
Oh, all right, it's worth a shot.
Okay, quiz questions for smart people. Okay, what year did the Panama Canal open?
1914.
And who designed the EMP Museum in
Frank
Seattle?
Gary!
Oh, you already knew. Yeah. Oh my gosh, okay. And what was Lyme disease named for?
The town it was discovered in.
And what was the first line of Anna Karenina?
All happy families are alike. Each unhappy family is unhappy in its own way.
A pound of?
Pastrami.
Okay, really?
I don't care.
All right.
Coleslaw.
All right, yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, bread?
Rye.
Okay, cheese?
Provolone.
Condiments?
Brown mustard.
Is any of this sound familiar?
No!
Damn! So,
I'll just order a pizza.
Oh. What about World War II?
Europe rebuilt.
Are you sure?
I'm so sorry.
It's fine.
No, I really apologize.
No problem.
Okay, goodbye.
See ya. Stand here and polish my spoon.
How you doing?
Fine.
Good. How's school?
Fine.
Good. Oh, how's that algebra grade?
Fine.
Yeah. Oh, how's, what's her name? Lily.
Fine.
Is it okay if we, if we talk?
I don't have anything to talk about.
That's not what it looks like.
Thank you.
Look, Zoe, I know things have been weird around here lately, what with Mom and me and our whole situation. And I know you're probably confused and maybe a little angry too.
I'm fine.
I know, but if you weren't.
I am.
Okay. But if at some point you decided that you're not, then I
won't.
Okay. You sure spend a lot of time with your friends.
So?
Nothing. I just thought it might be kind of nice to do something fun.
Being with my friends is fun.
I know, but no, I meant it might be fun for us to do something.
Us? Me and you?
Sure, well, look, I know your friends are important to you, but hey, we used to have fun together too, didn't we? You know, I mean, like movie marathons, and ball games, and daddy-daughter dinner nights.
Yeah, I was a little kid.
I know. But time gets away from us, you know? All of us, not just you and me. You always think there's tomorrow. So you put things off, and you put things off, and pretty soon you're out of tomorrows. And, well, there have been a lot of tomorrows since any of that happened.
Yeah, because I'm not a little kid anymore.
I know, Zoe, God, I know.
I've changed.
Well, everyone does.
You have, that's for sure.
Well, it's true.
Mom hasn't.
Yes, she has. Everyone does.
How?
Okay. It's like that show that you used to love. Remember the cartoon, the cat and the dog? They were friends. What was that show?
Talking about Mom.
Just follow me on this one. What was that show called?
Elf and Wally.
Right. Well, when you were younger, you used to love that show, but you don't feel that way about it anymore.
I still like it.
I know, but you've grown and your tastes have changed and. It's not the center of your universe like it used to be.
Yeah, what you like cartoons and music and corn dogs, that changes for everyone.
Oh, maybe not corn dogs.
But the people you love, that's not supposed to change.
Yeah, but they're similar, though. You know, relationships are hard. You know, like, really hard. God, and they're so complicated. They're practically a whole other person.
That doesn't make any sense.
Do you act the same way with me that you do with Lily?
No.
Of course not. And I don't act the same way with you that I do with my dad either.
Yes, you do.
No, honey, I can guarantee you that I've never discussed Ralph and Raleigh with your grandfather. Huh. They're very different relationships with very different personalities. And those change too, just like people. You know, when you were younger, you used to run and jump in my arms and yell, "I love you, Daddy." And now, if I may venture a guess, you don't often feel like doing that.
Yeah, because I'm not a little kid anymore.
Exactly. You know, you've changed. And so our relationship changed, too. And that's not a bad thing. That's just the way it is.
This is stupid.
Zoe. When you were first born, I could hold your head in the palm of my hand, and your feet reached my elbow. God, I can't believe you were ever that tiny. I remember thinking to myself, this is perfect. You know, everything's brand new and. Learning things at a faster rate than she ever will again. And then you started toddling around and using words. And I thought, no, this is the perfect age, you know? She's communicating. Oh, but she still likes to sit on my lap and have me read her a story. And then you started school. And I thought, ah, no, this is the perfect age, you know? She's gaining independence, and she's making friends. But she still likes to cuddle with me. And at every point in your life, I thought, this is perfect. Now freeze this moment. Time marched on. You changed, and I changed too. Because I had to. And you'll be driving soon, and I'll have to adapt to that. And then you'll be going away to college, and I'll have to adapt again. And then maybe someday you'll get married. And, I may never be able to adapt to that.
That's what kids do, they grow up. Grown-ups have stopped growing up, that's why they're called grown-ups.
Well, do you want to hear something weird? You never stop growing up. You know, which is good, I think, you know? You don't need me like you used to. You've changed, and I've changed too. Not just because of you, but that is a factor.
Mom didn't want change. You did. This is all your fault.
Well, yeah, you know, maybe it is. But change just happens sometimes, you know? I mean, eggs hatch, and seeds sprout, and lightning strikes, and kids grow, and not because somebody willed it.
Yeah, because all of that stuff is what's supposed to happen.
Yes, and all of that impacts something else.
So if my changes make you change, then maybe it's my fault.
No, honey. Honey, listen to me. You know, maybe Mom and I haven't handled things exactly the way we should have, but that's not your fault. You know, none of this is your fault.
You know that.
Our relationship with each other is different than our relationship with you.
And relationships are like people, that's what you said, right?
Yeah, well, sort of.
So there's you and Mom and your relationship together,
yeah.
And there's me and Mom and our relationship, and there's me and you and our relationship.
And then there's the relationship of all three of us together.
So that's like 10 people in one house.
Yeah. Hey, it's a wonder there's not a longer line for the bathroom.
So there's 10 people in one house. So what if my people started changing? Like, got all fat or something and started suffocating your people?
Okay.
Even though they didn't need to.
Mm-hmm.
And your people got all mad and my people were all just like, what?
Okay, maybe I didn't think through the analogy.
Then it would be my fault.
Honey, it is not. Trust me, please. What?
Nothing.
Tell me.
No.
Why not?
I don't think I want to know.
Huh.
What?
I just think it's important to realize before you ask a hard question whether or not you want to know the answer. It's a sign of maturity.
It is.
See? There you go, grown again.
Sorry.
Don't ever apologize for becoming who you are. Okay?
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
No problem.
No, I really apologize.
See ya.
Thanks. Okay, well, this has been bothering me for quite some time now, but I only recently realized exactly how much it's been impacting my job performance. So I was hoping that maybe we could sit down and come up with a way that no one has ever thought of before.
Sorry, hold on. This is Dick. Yeah, well, their regular order is 12 units of Tingle Touch and 10 units of Warming Gel, so that makes sense for the holidays. Sure. All right, thanks. Bye. Sorry, Liz, you were saying?
Well, Dick, I've been in institutional accounts for almost 4 months now. When Margaret left, it was a giant mess, no secret there. So I've been spending a lot of time trying to figure out what to do with these actual files. I mean, I found order files from Vice is Nice, Tab and Toy Box, and the Kinky Llama, and those accounts were closed years ago, so I was hoping maybe we could get together and come up with a way that no one else has to organize these...
Sorry, hold on. This is Dick! No, that's not your fault. I told him to speak to Robert about that. No, it isn't. Robert is in charge of all DVDs, even special interests. Yes, including amputees. Yep, it's no need to apologize. It's fine. All right, thanks. Bye. Sorry, Liz, you were saying? Sis Dick!
Is this a bad time?
It's all a bad time lately.
Should I come back later?
No, it's fine. It's just I'm getting ready for the annual. You're on the phone. Yeah, yeah. Sorry, I'm getting ready for the annual audit, and everyone's freaking out about that for some reason. And with Bradley being gone, I'm forced to pick up a lot of his duties, and we're right in the middle of the relay with the anal department, as well as all of my own. My own duties, not my own anal department.
Yeah. I knew what you meant.
I wish you could have planned his burst appendix better.
That's sensitive. How's he doing?
Oh, he's fine. I spoke to him the other day. He's planning on being back on Monday, and I thoroughly support him on that. But anyway, you took over institutional accounts for Margaret. She left a mess. You cleaned it up. Yada, yada, yada.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I have been sorting through these actual files for so long that I finally think I'm starting to see the light at the end of the tunnel. So I was hoping that maybe we could set up a new system involving product maintenance and ordering.
Sure, I'm all for it.
You know, like if we started with inflatables, insertables, media, buzzy toys.
Damn it! Inflatables!
What?
Nothing, I gotta get back to Peters.
Peters?
Peters O'Toole Box. They're new to the area, they're from the coast. They were asking about the Tina Tata doll.
Do they even still make that after the lawsuit?
Oh, they lay low for a while and rebranded. Now it's called Lorna Lust.
Because that's not like begging for legal action or anything.
What do you mean?
Lorna Luft.
No idea.
She's Judy Garland's daughter.
Really? Why would they
call her? Good question. Anyway, I was hoping that we could come up with a way to organize these files, like I was thinking.
Sorry. This is Dick! Huh. Well, I don't know. We've never heard anything like that before. Yeah. I might need to look into health code ordinances or something. Yeah, right. Okay, well, let me tell you what. Why don't you send me over his contact info, and I'll get an answer and send it right back. I don't know how I feel about it, to be honest, but can't make the decision on my own, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. All right, thanks. Bye. Huh.
What?
I didn't even know they made such a thing as an edible plug.
No.
Yeah.
Why?
Destroy the evidence?
Oh, God, stop!
Which is why I'll have to do more research when Bradley gets back.
Oh, yeah, speaking of health.
I should grab him while he's in the hospital. Give him, like a sampler platter.
Oh, no, don't do that.
What? It's the perfect place in case the product is...
No, I understood. Just please don't.
Aren't you judgy all of a sudden?
Oh, gee, all it took, finally, was a product that you eat after it's been in a butt.
We don't know that for sure. It could be a gag gift. Wait, listen.
What?
Nothing.
Oh!
Quick,
okay,
before the thing doesn't happen.
I'm making this day and age, we can order a computer.
God damn it! This is Dick! Liz? Yeah, she's right here. Well, we've been trying to have a meeting, but the phone just keeps ringing off the hook. Oh, he is? All right.
Yeah, I'll send her right over. No, it's fine. It's fine. Okay. All right, thanks. Bye. Alan from Orifice Depot's here.
You put an appointment in for another hour.
Sorry.
Oh, got it. Oh, we did move it up.
You want to reschedule this?
No.
No?
Why don't we try this after Bradley gets back?
You know, that would be better. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, no problem.
I really apologize.
Oh, it's really fine.
Okay, goodbye.
Yeah. See ya.
Mistake how I even started drinking that in the first place.
What kind of... What is it you want?
What do I want? Funny. Do you know that before I ever even tasted alcohol, I used to listen to what other people would order? Maybe not intentionally, but it was like some part of me needed to know what to do when the time came, what was expected of me. First beer, I expected something amazing, because everybody else drank it, but I didn't, but I was supposed to love it, so I pretended, kept pretending. Got really good at it. So one day I just sort of got used to it, still didn't really like it though, but everybody else did, so I must be wrong. Recently that somebody suggested that I, Travis actually suggested that I try it again.
Travis?
What?
Who are you? Tonight?
Yeah, I'm here with Travis.
What is it you want?
What I want? What I thought I wanted? This isn't just about Peter, this is my life. Supposed to want, but it wasn't true. Just got caught up in it. I fit in. It's what everyone else was doing, so I just went along with it.
Travis is nice.
Hmm. Yeah. He's really nice.
Kind of cute, too.
He's also smart, funny.
Like you, honey.
Yeah. Well, we've been spending a lot of time together.
Mm-hmm.
We've gotten really close. We have a lot in common. It's almost like I've known him longer than I really have. Like brothers, almost.
Honey,
I guess. Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
Have you come to bed?
I gotta tell you something.
What?
I didn't.
Hold me.
Julia.
Matthew, I'm cold. I need you.
Julia?
Yeah.
Look, me so long to even consider. What if I... I'm so sorry.
No problem.
I really apologize.
Hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Fine.
What do you want?
Well, Professor, I want to confirm that I'm seeing what I think I'm seeing.
What do you think you're seeing?
I think it's a... Well, I'll just let you look and see what you think it is. But if I'm right, it's pretty unusual. I'm trying to contain myself before you verify my ID. Over there, in the tree second from the left, with two major branches that sort of make an X. See it?
Not yet.
Okay. You see, on the left, the tree with the twisty branches.
Oh, there's a bearded tit. Oh, I'm so sorry, Kate. What were you saying?
On the left, the tree with the branches that are twisty.
Okay.
Right to the left of that tree, the tree with the knothole, and the two major branches that sort of make an X.
What, across the clearing?
No, that's left.
You said left.
I said second from the left.
But then you said the tree to the left of the tree on the left. But to the left of the tree on the left, there's no tree left.
Right.
There's a clearing on the left.
No, right, not left.
Right of the tree or right of the clearing?
Right, yes, right.
Which right?
Both right. Right of the trees and right of the clearing.
Okay. Which tree?
The tree.
The tree on the left to the right of the clearing?
Right.
Yeah. Oh.
The tree is on the left of the trees, and the trees are to the right of the clearing.
Right.
Right.
So, I'm looking to the right of the clearing at the tree on the left, right?
Right.
Right. And then?
The tree on the right.
Of the tree on the left.
Right. All right. Left to right.
Oh.
There's a hazel tree. Then a huge walnut.
Where is the hazel tree?
On the left, the far, far left.
Oh.
You see it?
Yes, with the dead branch.
Right, yeah. Right. So there's the hazel tree, then a huge walnut tree, then a bushy thing, and some underbrush.
Yes, got it.
Yes, then there are two smaller trees to the left of a much larger one.
And that's the tree to the left of the clearing.
Right. Correct.
Yes. So there's the clearing, and then to the right is...
The tree with twisty branches.
Right, and then...
The tree with a knot hole.
Right.
No left. Oh, yes, right. And then about a third of the way up, where the two major branches seem to sort of make it...
What?
Damn.
Well, it's gone. Well, what was it?
I think it was... It probably wasn't.
Well, describe it.
Even if it was... Yes, we'll never know now.
Well, we could contact the Ornithological Society. Perhaps you're not the only one who saw it.
Just... God. I'll call you over if it comes back.
Hey. This sort of thing happens a lot. It's what makes a positive ID so difficult. and so rewarding when you actually do it. I'm so sorry.
No problem. I really apologize.
That's fine.
All right. Goodbye.
See you.
Wrong.
No, everything's fine, Mom.
Because, you know, I thought that you and the kids...
No, everyone's fine.
Oh, are the kids here?
wake you?
No, no, no.
Oh, no, 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 no. Did I wake the children?
No, no, they're all fine, Mom.
Oh, you know, I really want to see them.
They'll be here soon.
I miss them.
They miss you too.
They do?
Well, of course. You're very important to them. They love you.
No. No, no. Something's wrong, right?
You're just
right.
Tired, Mom.
Something's missing. I feel like something's
shifted. Mom, you just need to get some rest.
Eddie? Oh, Eddie, when did you get here? I'm so happy to see you.
I just got here now, Mom, but I'm really tired.
Oh.
You know, Mom, I'm happy to see you, too.
Oh.
But, you know,
Eddie,
we can catch up tomorrow.
You know what? I woke you up again. I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's fine, Mom. Don't worry.
No, I really apologize.
It's fine.
Okay. Okay. Goodbye.
See you, Mom.
Okay, let's...
No? Yeah.
Oh, you know what? We need to call Eddie and the children.
No,
we need to use the right now.
Oh, more regular! Oh my God, I'm on a roll!
Fine. What do you want?
Just your everlasting love. Maybe a cup of milk if you can spare it.
You scared the hell out of me just busting in like that. I thought you had to work tonight.
Oh, yeah, I'm sick. So what are you doing?
Nothing. Why?
I'm just looking for something to do. You want to do whatever it is with me?
No. Thank you.
Please?
I'm not in the mood.
Come on, Chris, I'm bored.
I don't want to.
Want to go to a movie?
No.
Dinner?
No.
A walk?
No.
Coloring books?
What?
Coloring books!
Paul, why did you bring coloring books to my house?
Because I knew you'd say no to going out, but who can say no to coloring?
Oh, guess what? I can, because it's stupid.
Well, if it's so stupid, then how come it's so popular?
It's popular with little kids.
Yeah, but that's just because we get so caught up with book reports and algebra and job interviews and reality television, and we forget how great coloring is.
No, it's because we grow the hell up, you know?
Yeah, same thing.
No. It's not the same thing, you know, because growing the hell up means war and poverty and famine and terrible world leaders and orphans. And being unable to affect any kind of actual change because you're weak and pitiful and exhausted.
Then how do you explain the adult coloring book fad?
The adult?
No, not like born adult. No, I'm talking about like the intricate small motor skills adult. How do you explain that?
You know, I don't know, Paul, and I don't care, so go.
You know what? This room has the perfect light for coloring.
Stop.
No, I never realized how bright this room is.
Okay. You know what? I don't have any crayons here.
Now what kind of idiot do you think that I am? No, don't answer that.
Asshole.
I said don't answer that.
I hate you.
Yeah, your pants are on fire. Now, which one do you want?
None of them. I'm not doing any stupid coloring. So, go.
No?
Yes, go.
Not gonna happen.
Why not?
Because I love you, and I miss you, and I'm staying right here. You know, even if we don't go to a movie, even if we don't have dinner, even if we don't color. But I really want to color.
No.
Also, I'm gonna want to eat.
Yeah, okay. Well, you know what? I don't want you here. So go.
Not gonna happen.
Why not?
Because I told you I love you.
All right. Well, I say bullshit. You know why? You know what, Paul? I say bullshit. You know why? Because, like, the whole world is a giant stinking piece of shit, right? And I'm a teeny tiny piece of shit swimming in a sea of shit. And this whole world would be a lot better if there was a little less shit in it, right?
Not everything is shit. I mean, there's me.
You're fine, you know? And you will always be fine.
No. Not without you. You're my fine.
Do not understand.
Well, maybe I don't. You know, but I'm trying, and I will never not try. And if I can't, we will find someone who can, and we can make fun of his shoes together, because I'm sure his shoes will be laughable.
You are exhausting.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Fine, I'm not coloring.
Oh, okay. You can just watch me then.
Why'd you pick that one?
Because I love these guys. Have you never seen this show?
No.
No? You mean I've never made you watch this show?
No.
Oh my God, I'm a bad friend.
No, you're definitely not a
bad friend. Well, this proves otherwise. Okay, all right. So, we have a plan.
Oh, really? What plan do we have?
Well, tomorrow, I introduce you to the joys of children's programming. But tonight, we color. Here.